Why India and Japan are joining forces for semiconductors? What's going on with the semiconductor scene? India seems to have an aspiration to become a major semiconductor hub. So, what's new? In July 2023, it was reported that India is signing an MOU with Japan, which is a memorandum of understanding. This may be a way to boost India's semiconductor ambitions and grow its global supply chain plans. An MOU is basically a formal and non-binding legal agreement between two or more parties like India and Japan. There are some terms outlined and the MOU provides a framework for future discussions and negotiations. The MOU between India and Japan is regarding semiconductor development, design, manufacturing, equipment research, talent development and more. The aim is said to be creating a robust and resilient value chain for the semiconductor industry. India's Union Minister for Electronics IT currently is Ashwini Vaishnav. He has called this substantial step towards establishing a complete value chain. This collab could create a strong semiconductor supply chain, especially with global companies diversifying beyond China. There have earlier collabs with the US and Japan to nurture India's semiconductor sector. India is said to have strong design capabilities and could be an attractive destination for semiconductor manufacturing. India would also sign agreements with institutions like Georgia Tech University and has inked one with Cardwell University. Japan has around 100 semiconductor manufacturing plants, so it holds a prominent position in global semiconductor ecosystem. Japanese companies such as Kioxia, NEC Corporation and Sony would be able to participate in India's semiconductor incentive schemes. And Japan could provide India with knowledge transfer and developments in latest technology. But it's said that Japan may be a bit closed off when sharing information. Maybe India could ensure just how committing Japan is by leveraging its geopolitical importance, having strategic ties with other countries. That being said, maybe India shouldn't just rely on one geopolitical partner. Maybe like a finfluencer would say, diversify. Partnerships with the US and Japan are crucial, but India could still explore collabs with other countries to make sure there is a secure and diversified supply chain. According to McKinsey, the global semiconductor industry is poised to become a $1 trillion industry by 2030, and India aims to play a big role. Where will India be positioned in the highly competitive global semiconductor ecosystem?